Hello everyone. Today in this presentation video, we'll be discussing about international technology transfer, various channels through which technology can be transferred, generally from developed nations to developing nations, and we'll be taking one particular case of the Indian automotive oil industry and how it benefited from the technology transfer. During the 1970s, there was a major debate, international debate, about technology transfer. That concerns were that the cost of technology was too high, and the host nation which uses the technology was often regulated by restrictive clauses, and the licenses often failed to receive the best technology. Today, the world is a different place, mainly because of two major reasons. First of them is globalization. Globalization has led economies of scale in many businesses and favor companies that serve multiple countries. The production chains are now often spread over a number of nations. For example, computer chips are designed by one nation, manufactured in the second one, tested in the third nation, assembled in the fourth one, and the software is written in the fifth one. Second, you can see that the number of developing nations have become much more technologically sophisticated. As we see in the slide, there is a significant increase in the number of trained workforce, the level of science-based industry, and the magnitude of national scientific research and financing programs in developed nations. Moving on to the next slide, let us try and define technology. International Code of Conduct of Transfer Technology defines technology as the systematic knowledge for the manufacture of a product, for the application of a process, or for the rendering of a service, and does not extend to the transactions involving the mere sale or lease of goods. For example, computer is not a technology in itself, but the way or how to operate on manufacturing is actually the technology transfer. Further moving ahead, in the next slide, let us discuss the channels of international technology transfer. The major channel is trade in goods and services. All export bears some potential for transmitting technological information, but they may be studied for design characteristics and reverse engineering. The second one of the important ones is foreign direct investment through multinational enterprises. The primary motivation of a firm to become multinational is the ownership of some knowledge-based asset that provides us the cost or quality advantage and that can be adapted and employed in multiple locations. FDI is a major conduit through which firms compete globally in technology. Licensing. Licenses typically involve the purchase of production or distribution rights and the technical information and know-how required to make effective the exercise of those rights. Joint ventures. Licenses and FDIs are closely related to the establishment of joint ventures, which are contractual agreements between two or more firms in which each provides us with some technological advantage to reduce the cost of joint operations. In the context, we can take, for example, an international firm may provide technically superior production information through licensing, while the local partners may provide distribution networks, brand recognition, unique management techniques, labor market, and some other local advantages. Whether the basic research to apply technology from one firm to another, the transfer of technology is fundamentally a matter of flow of human knowledge from one human being to the another. This can be through education, scientific literature, or even direct human communication. Further, there are various publicly developed technology which are government supported, NGO supported, and there are various privately developed technology. And these are the various channels through which actually technology develops and transfers. Now, let us look into the Indian automobile sector. During the 1980s, the national government thought of promoting development of automobile sector, and the policies were taken accordingly. The major focus of Prime Minister Indira Gandhi at that time was to develop a mass transportation vehicle which is accessible to the Indian middle class. So the government, I'd like to say that during independence, there were two major auto makers in India, which were Hindustan Motors and Premier Automobiles. The market was majorly supply driven and very few people had access to cars. In the 1981, government decided to go for a joint venture with Suzuki Motors of Japan which Suzuki Motors had 26% stake in it. There were various several concessions offered for the joint venture to develop a small mass medium car for the medium class. Suzuki introduced various Japanese techniques such as quality circles, vendor collaborations, and continuous improvement for fully exploiting the technical talent of the local workforce. Consequently, localization of parts, sub-assemblies, and product design were rapidly achieved. The first car, which was Maruti 800, launched in 1983, was a runaway success. Since then, there have been many foreign firms. Probably till 2000, there were around 17 foreign firms established their manufacturing operations in India. Many local players also were attracted towards it, such as Mahindra and Mahindra, which were basically a tractor manufacturing company. The automobile sector in 2000 had a turnover of around 20 billion and employed around 0.45 million people directly and 10 million people indirectly. And it had a huge contribution to the GDP of the country. Further, let us see what are the current trends of Indian automobile sector. India is one of the largest tractor and three-wheel vehicle producer, second largest two-wheel vehicle producer, fourth largest commercial vehicle producer, 11th largest passenger car producer. And you see the cumulative annual growth of the automotive exports during the period of 2001 to 2005-2006 was 32.92%. Among the leading car companies which have invested in India are US automakers such as General Motors and Ford, Germany's BMW and Daimler Chrysler, France's Renault, Japan's Suzuki, Toyota, Honda, and South Korea's Hyundai. Further, India is an attractive outsourcing destination for global auto companies because of its strong engineering skills and low cost. Sourcing parts from India is around 10 to 20% cheap for the US automakers and almost 50% cheap for the European automakers. Now, I'd like to conclude that the international flow of technological information and its successful integration into domestic production and management processes are central to the ability of developing countries to compete in global economy and to narrow the technological gaps they face compared to developed countries. International technology transfer is a comprehensive term covering mechanisms for shift information across borders and its effective diffusion into recipient economies. Thus, it refers to numerous complex processes ranging from innovation and international marketing of technology to its absorption and imitation. Further, I'd like to also say that these processes, which include technology, trade and investment policies, can affect the term of access of knowledge. Policy making in this area is especially complex and needs careful consideration, both by individual countries and at multilateral levels. Thank you.